Welcome to the great Exodus series, God's plan of rescue for his children. Let my people go. The path to Mount Zion. My name is Michael. I'm the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And this video is a continuation, the second part of our topic, sharing of resources, a commandment of the Lord. It is not only about helping the poor, the needy, the nameless and faceless. It is also about coming together in love, unity and support. Because we at Triple Grace see that it's our work in our ministry that we will gather the people together in love, unity and support so that they can share their resources, support one another during the sealed tribulation. Because the Lord has told us that we should prepare right now, because the seals will be opened very soon. And during the sealed tribulation, when we walk out of the world and out of Babylon towards the holy mountain, the mountain not carved with human hand, Mount Zion, then we need to come together and share resources and support one another. And our societies of the rose all over the world will come forth to support one another, no matter what calamity will strike and no matter what disaster will come. And these societies of the rose, these assemblies of love and righteousness can be then protected by our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And we will be under the wings of our Abba Father. So it's not only about the poor and the needy, but also about supporting one another and sharing resources with the true Christian in your societies of the rose, in your neighborhood, so that the true Christian will make it alive to the holy mountain, to be part of the rapture, to be part of the multitude clothed in white. So without any further ado, let me go now to our next article that will allow us to reason about sharing of resources, a commandment of the Lord. God commands us to help the poor. Unfortunately, I think things like our own wealth or politics or even the media sometimes give us wrong ideas about poverty. I hear people repeat the phrase, well, God helps them who help themselves, which is not a verse in the Bible. In fact, it's the exact opposite of what the Bible teaches. The gospel teaches us that God saved us when we were helpless in our sins, and in the same way, the Bible commands us to help the helpless and the needy in our world, who sometimes can't help themselves. In fact, if you look all the way back in the Old Testament, you will see that God has always asked the people to provide for the poor. This was not merely making a suggestion or even a request or something God's people did only if they felt like it. God commanded his people to feed the poor, often in very specific ways. Leviticus 19:9-10. When you harvest the crops of your land, do not harvest the grain along the edges of your fields, and do not pick up what the harvesters drop. Do not strip every last bunch of grapes from the vines, and do not pick up the grapes that fall to the ground. Leave them for the poor and the foreigners living among you. I am the Lord your God. This practice is called gleaning. God told them not to pick the grain along the edges of the field, or take every grape off all the branches. Whether the harvester accidentally dropped was to be left for the poor or take home to eat as well. This was God's practical way for the Israelites to provide food for the poor. This is the same method that food banks follow today. God expects his genuine followers to care for those in need. The same priorities apply in the New Testament, James 1:27. Pure and genuine religion in the sight of God the Father means caring for the orphans and widows in the distress and refusing to let the world corrupt you. Again, God commands you to help the poor and needy in practical ways. If you want to sincerely and genuinely worship God, then care for the orphans and meet their needs. Take care of the widows in their grieving and in their inability to take care of themselves. Back then, most women were uneducated and had no real skills to earn much money to take care of their family. Losing a husband, most women would end up poor and hungry, possibly living in the streets. So on this verses, James picked up the most two vulnerable groups of people he could think of and tells us that if we want to obey God, then we need to take care of the poor. Wishful thinking and good thoughts are never enough. What do you do when you see a friend on social media say something like they just lost their job, or they are falling behind on their finances, or they are facing some high medical bills? I see too many people respond with comments like, sending good thoughts your way, hoping things work out for you, or the worst one is they just push the like button on their comment. What do you do when you see a homeless man on the street with a sign that says he needs money or food? I'm not saying you should stop and give him anything, but the worst thing you could do is roll down your car window and yell, "Hey, I'm praying for you," and roll up your window again and drive away. James 2:15-16. Listen carefully, all you mockers and scoffers. Suppose you see a brother or sister who has no food or clothing, and you say goodbye and have a good day, stay warm and eat well, but then you don't give that person any food or clothing. What good does that do? God commands us to put our faith and love into action and to do something about the needs of the poor. He wants us to feed the hungry, to clothe the needy, and to help figure out ways to shelter the homeless in a way that will help them get back on their feet again. Now, if you see these people, people of God, you see so many of the scriptures and verses that God commands us to help the poor and the needy. How much more will he then be interested that we come together in love, unity, and support, that we share our resources, and that we support one another, especially in the time of the seals that will come up now, the seal tribulation. You will not make it alive to Mount Zion, the mountain not carved by human hands, if you are not sharing your resources, come together in societies of the Rose and support one another. If you stay alone in the world, you will die a martyr's death, or you will join the Antichrist by receiving the mark. But if you come out of the world and out of Babylon in the great Exodus, what we proclaim in our ministry day after day in every of our videos, and you come together like the Israelites coming out of Egypt and sharing their resources, coming together, support one another and love one another, then you will reach Mount Zion alive, and you will be raptured into paradise to be with the Father and his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, forever and ever. This was our second part about sharing resources, a commandment of the Lord. Let us reason together. Tomorrow we will make a third part with another article. This article for today, I will put a link in the first bit comment so that you can follow and read it. Read also all the Bible verses about helping the needy, the children, the widows, the orphans. And please assist us in our case with Baby Grace, assist us with our mission to Cambodia where we help the children. We are commanded to do that. And if any needs arise, this need should be met by the community, by the true Christians coming together to support one another. Because if we have a need today and it will be met by a community, next time another person has a need, then we can also skip in to help. But if we are all falling by the wayside, then at the end there will be no community left, because everybody will have died off. So come together in love, unity, and support. This is our ministry of Triple Grace, to build societies of the Rose in the nation and to guide you in the great Exodus through the seal tribulation so that you reach Mount Zion alive. And we do that by sharing resources, caring for one another and supporting one another, coming together in unity. That is always what Abba Father wanted and what Jesus wanted. He has always called you together into unity and brotherly love. Thank you that you have listened to this topic today, and I hope I will see you again tomorrow. Have a great day. Maranatha.